Hi and welcome back, my name is Emily. In this video I'm going to use a stamp set from Maker Forte called Sketch Peony. This stamp set is designed by Alex Saberia and it features all of these large flower images, and I am in love with the style of these flowers. And they are really big, so you can really practice your coloring today. And I will create two cards with this stamp set, and I will use Copic markers and watercolors for my cards today. I started off by laying out some of the stamps that I wanted to use for my cards today, and I just arranged them in a cluster down to towards the right corner, just because I wanted to see how it would look. And then I started to stamp, and I also created masks. I think I only will be using one mask today. I used one for that larger flower, and then I will arrange my other filler images around it. And you can see I can stamp a lot of them at once when I'm doing it like this. And I'm using Memento, that is a great ink for Copic coloring. And when I'm done with this, I removed my mask and I saw that I thought it looked a little bit empty down there, so I actually created one more mask, for my little flower there, just to make one more leaf into the cluster before I removed everything and called it down. And then I will go in with my Copic markers here, and they will be listed up in the corner which colors I used. I believe it's R35 and R32 that I used for the red parts here, and I will speed this up I think 6 times for you, because I know that a lot of people doesn't like to look at all the coloring. I personally like it sometimes, but sometimes I just want to see the finished results. So I sped this through quite a lot, because I think you get the idea of this anyway. And of course I'm not that fast at coloring at all. I'm actually taking a lot of time when I'm doing my Copic coloring, because I'm, as I say in all my videos, I'm no expert at coloring at all. I just like to see the image come to life, and I like to create my cards and think out how I want everything to look in the end. So this is not my strongest side, to like color everything in. I know like people that are really good, they really create it like it looks like there is a real flower, but I just want some shading, then I'm happy with my results. So for the green here, I took a color combination. I think I used 3 markers. They are listed up in the corner as well. And I just went around, make sure that I had some dimension in color here as well. I kept the darker parts toward the center of my leaf. Then I went in with another dot stamp set that I have in my stash. This is also one from Maker Forte. It will be linked down below. And I created all of these dots just to create some dimension to my project. And I also went in with a stencil on top of this. I didn't do any masking here. I just was careful to go around my images, and I used a really light gray to do this. And I'm sorry, my camera died when I did this, so all the coloring that I did with my watercoloring and everything, I didn't get on camera, so I'm sorry about that. But I think it was quite basic what I did. But this is a really fun part. I love this. I used some score tape here and I created my own pattern. You can see I don't even measure this. It was so easy to create. I just wanted some different like sizes and the different width between them. And then I cut off the excess and I will remove all the release paper on top of it. And then I will go in with some black glitter. This is also from Maker Forte. It's called Holographic Eclipse. And it's super beautiful. I don't think the camera does it justice. It's really, really pretty. So in a second here, you can see that I will go in with this and just pouring it over the surface of where the adhesive is exposed. And you can see that the glitter grabs onto my car base here. And I really wanted to burnish this into my black paper. By the way, this is also black cardstock from Maker Forte. It's called Eclipse, so these colors really match. I know you can't believe that black cannot be black, but sometimes it isn't black when it's black, but this really is a super black cardstock and I love it. So that I also love that it coordinates with this glitter perfectly. So I loved it, and I didn't want to take away too much from my background, so I decided to create a cluster with all my flowers here that I created. And I don't know if you could see previously that I had colored in some more flowers that I had gold heat embossed, but I decided not to use them in this project. I thought it was too much. Now I'm going in and just creasing some of the flowers and the leaves to create some more dimension. And I when I'm happy with all of that, I will adhere this straight down to a top folded card base. This one is also from Maker Forte. You can buy these in packs. And I heat embossed a sentiment on top of a black cardstock that says happy birthday, and that finished off our project for today. I also went into the center part with these Nuvo jewel drops, and this will dry clear, and it's called Lemoncello, this color that I used. And that is the project for today. I hope you liked it. If you did, I would be super happy if you could considering subscribing to the channel and leave me a comment and maybe a thumbs up if you haven't done so yet. You can also hit the bell button and you will get notified every time I have a new video. Until next time, have a great day. Bye!